3, 2, 1, you're on.
There are places I remember.
My name is Rosemary Pedro.
And how long have you lived here?
At least 55, 56 years. Let's see. 1947 to now. So it's 59, actually. It's been decorated and redecorated and redecorated in all those years. Hasn't been anything done to it in 9 years, so. It was nice. It was good. Ups and downs, just like everybody. We didn't have everything everybody else had, but we were happy. We didn't know we didn't have everything like everybody else, because that's the way we had. We did with what we had, money-wise.
Well, here it is. Joey, Jerry, Donald, Rosemary, Kathy, Patty, Maureen, Carol, and Mary Beth.
My name is Joseph Pedro, and I'm number one.
Donald, I'm number three.
My name is Rosemary Pedro Hudson. I'm fourth oldest.
My name is Patty, and I am number six.
My name is Carol, and I'm number eight in a family of nine.
My name is Mary Beth. I'm the youngest.
I treasure this picture because they surprised us with it one Christmas. And they all got together one Saturday morning, and they went to have this picture taken. In Westfield. Look at them. Look at them. Look at Joe. He's probably on dope.
No, she only thinks she told you about that.
Well, she told us about you in the picture.
That she only thinks she told you about me. What'd she tell you about the shirt? I had forgotten about it. And underneath my shirt, I have my work overalls on. I had been working. And it was dirty. But I had, the shirt was in the trunk. I don't even know where I got it from. And somebody said, you're gonna have your picture taken like that? And I said, what picture? Because we're having our family picture taken. Oh. So I ran out and took this shirt that I don't think I ever wore it again. I don't even know where it came from. I put it on, and that's where the shirt came from. That's in that picture.
I had two very loving parents. And got along pretty much with everyone in my family, but you know, space was tight. Fighting for attention was super tight.
There was always someone there. You always had someone with, you know, to hang out with or talk to.
Yeah, you're never alone. You're always you always have companionship. And even today, I don't. I'm not too crazy about being alone.
There was some territorial issues with clothes and stuff like that, but we all got beyond it.
You know, it was a happy type of a home, because Nanny and Pop-Up were, you know, very happy. You know, it was like a lot of nurturing, you know? I don't know how to explain it.
I always slept with somebody else in my bed and took a bath with somebody else in the bathtub.
I babysat all the time. I mean, that's a given. There's no... You know, you just knew that that's what happened. There were certain nights and days that it was just part of your schedule.
You know, it was like I was closer, of course, to the younger ones. I didn't really know my older sisters and brothers until I'm older now. I'm getting to know them.
And that's one of the things that's hard. Like, I don't remember how old everyone is. I know my youngest sister is 4 years younger than me, and the ones that are close to me, I know their age, but my oldest brother, I believe, is about 24 years older than me.
Being the oldest, you, like I said, you, it's a different life. You know, I moved along, and they tell me stories of how they used to watch my friends come over. I never was around to watch their friends come over.
I remember, oh, another thing I remember, too, is when I went in the Air Force, I thought I was going for, like, a death sentence. They were hysterical, like I was being brought to the gas chamber at Newark Airport. That was pretty funny, too.
Well, they used to always come for breakfast. We'd have everything, whatever they wanted, pancakes, French toast, eggs, bacon, sausage, juice, rolls. And that's what we had, and everybody had come. Right now, I have 21 grandchildren, 4 great-grandchildren, plus 3 step-grandchildren, and I guess it's 2 step-great-grandchildren.
Our family gatherings are large, loud, we laugh a lot, we cry sometimes, but we do like getting together. When all the kids were younger, all you guys were younger, it was fun because they were all the kids got together and the sisters got together. And
I have a lot of nieces and nephews, which I personally cherish tremendously.
Joe's the 21st. Well, yeah, Joe's the 21st. You have 21. And it's changed in a way that it's not as easy to get together with everyone. You know, there's so many people and so many different families going in so many different directions. So it's not as easy to get everyone together. Yeah. You know, but when we are all together, as much as we have a lot of differences, each one of us is so different and has different ideas and don't agree on things, when we're all together, it's awesome, I think. Even though it's very, very rare. You know? And what else?
Did anybody mention the Christmases and things that happened at Christmas time?
Christmases were like the best, I think. You got everything. You know, you might not have gotten much around the year, but at Christmas, it was like
magic. Like, you know, like you would think of Christmas in a storybook. I went to bed at night, and our tree wasn't there or wasn't decorated, and I woke up in the morning, and it was lights and tinsels and decorations and, you know.
Santa Claus, i.e. me and my dad, we put up the Christmas tree.
Well, Santa Claus decorated our tree after we went to bed. Our Santas used to put rugs down, bring us our Christmas clothes to wear the next day.
I don't know, did anybody talk about the underpants on their heads and things like that?
Us wearing underwear on our head, banging on the floor to see if we could come down. You know, because we always went to bed with no tree, no nothing, and then woke up the next morning, everything was there.
Well, Christmas was a busy time. In between shoveling the snow, wrapping gifts, and putting up Christmas trees and outside lights.
We were up until about 5 o'clock putting bikes together and toys together. And we'd get in bed at 5 o'clock and all of a sudden we'd hear the kids knocking at the, can we come down, can we come down? They'd come down and look at the tree and say, oh, he was here, Santa Claus was here. And then we, you know, then we'd have to get up even though we were so tired, we were half asleep.
You know, you'd get your presents in the morning. Then in the afternoon they had more surprises in the basement. Then at night it was exchange gifts. Like it was all day long gifts. All day long. Yeah, and the house always looked good. The house always looked its best at Christmas. Clean, everything bright and shiny and clean. That was always my favorite time of the year.
And always getting shortchanged because my birthday was the 29th. So I'd always get like the smallest pile. But we always had good Christmases.
Pop-Pop always took out the movies. And at that time you had the big thing with all the lights on it, and it blinded you. But he would stand there with that, taking the movies, and, you know.
That was probably the best memories. Christmas was truly a very special time in my family.
There's something a lot of people don't consider, though. From 1 to 9, everybody didn't have the same parents. There's a lot of changes that happened in 20 years. So the parents that I had, 20 years later, they had my younger sister. They were the different people than the first parents that had me.
Papa was great, the best guy. His name was Joe, but I called him Fat and Hon. That's it. He was the only man I ever went out with, my only boyfriend. And I knew him from the eighth grade, even sixth grade, when I used to watch him play softball. And then eighth grade, you know, I was a little older then. I really had a crush on him. And then we went to movies on Sunday, and that was it. We didn't have any heavy dating or anything. And I went to my senior prom with him. And I graduated in 1939, and we got married in 1942. And that's it. And he died in 1997. At 77,
was it? Yeah, 77. My Nanny and Papa, my God, they're the best. I would give anything to have the kind of relationship my mother and father had.
Even though he worked so hard, he always did everything he could do for us. You know, and that's part of why everything was so special.
Dad's raising 9 kids. He's working 2 8-hour jobs for like 15 years.
He was a tool and die maker, cigarette manufacturing company for a long time. And then he worked in Park Classic. He worked at Singer 16 years and Park Classic 16 years. And then he went back to Singer's for I forget how many years.
One time, New Jersey Bell sent me to Singer's in Elizabeth to install some data equipment on a machine that was going to be computer driven, and my father happened to be the guy that I was there with. Just a coincidence. Then of course they get to showboat me. This is my son, Donald, blah, blah, blah. You know, I'm still, you know, every time I go to New Jersey, my mother introduces me to the same people over and over again.
When I was growing up, it was just him having to make money. And that's all, you know, just for survival. You know, nothing moving up the social ladder or anything like that. It was just him.
And he loved Nanny a whole lot. I mean, it was, you could always tell they were in love. You know, they had their arguments and stuff, but everybody does, but they were very special. He was a nice man, everybody loved him, so.
You know, they had a good marriage, they were good for each other, and they raised, you know, their family, I think, pretty good, considering 9 kids. I don't know how they did it.
That's about it. What else can I say? And if I had to do it over again, I would. I'd do the same thing over again, if I could. There are places. That's it.
Thank you very much, Nan. I love you.
I love you, too.
Though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone. And some remain. All these places have their moments. With lovers and friends, I still can recall. Some are dead and some are living. In my life, I've loved them all.